Hey, welcome back to my new video. This is Easy Tutorials, and for those of you who are the first time in this channel, please consider subscribing. Today we'll be creating a page turn logo reveal animation like in the following example. Before we start, I'd like to invite you to support me on Patreon. You can also get access to all my premium content. In this tutorial, we'll be using the Easy Tool script, which is free to download. You can get it by clicking the link from the upper right corner of this screen. You can also download the template of this animation by following the link from the description. So let's start. Import the files you need into After Effects. Create a new composition and name it, Page Turn Logo Reveal. I'm using a Full HD, 1080 pixels preset, with 30 frames per second, and 7 seconds long. Create a new black solid, and name it BG. Apply the ramp effect to it. Open the Effect Controls panel from here, and let's make some changes. Change this value to 540. This one to 4000. Change the start color to any color you like. I'll be using this shade of blue. Change the ramp shape to radial ramp. The ramp scatter to 50. Then, click the swap colors button, and you will get a nice background, just like mine. Bring your logo inside this composition. The logo I've used is very big, so I will have to open the scale property, and scale it down to 22% in my case. Now, select the logo and pre-compose it. Let's name the new composition logo placeholder. Go to the Effects and Presets panel and search for CC Page Turn. Apply it to your layer, and make these following changes. Change the controls to top left corner. Move to the 15th frame, and create a keyframe on fold position. Change this value to 2730. And this one to 760. Move to 2 seconds. And change the values to 1010 and 650. In this position, create a keyframe on fold radius. Then, move back to the 15th frame and change its value to 400. Reveal all the keyframes of this layer, select them and easy ease them. Then, open the graph editor, select these handles, and drag them all the way to the left. This is what we have until now. Make sure to be on your first frame, and make the layer 3D. Open the scale property, create a keyframe, then, change any of these values to 0%. Move 1 second forward, and change the values back to 100%. Select both keyframes, and easy ease them. Your animation should look like this. Search for Find Edges and apply it to your layer. Select the invert box. Then, alt-click this stopwatch, and type the next expression. Open bracket, index. Minus, 1, closed bracket. Multiply by 10. Now, select your layer, and duplicate it 9 times. On the top layer, select the Find Edges effect, and delete it. Select the 9 top layers, and offset then 5 frames to the right. Repeat the action with all the other layers. Our animation should look like this now. Select all the logo placeholders layers, pre-compose them and name the new composition, Logo Animation. Make it 3D. Create a null layer. Make it 3D too. Then link your logo animation layer to it. Make sure to be in the first frame. Open the position property. Create a keyframe, and change the Y value to 440. Move to the last frame, and change the Z value to 220. Select this last frame and ease in it. Select the logo animation layer, and duplicate it. Rename the bottom one, Logo Shadow. Open its scale property. Unlink the values. And change the Y value to 55%. Open the position property. And change the Y value to 440. Apply the fill effect to it. And change the color to a medium shade of gray. Apply the fast blur effect to it, and change the blurriness to 200. Select the layer, open the opacity, and change its value to 50%. Create a new adjustment layer, and rename it CC. Apply curves to it. And create a simple curve like this, to make the colors pop up a little. Now, bring the audio file inside this composition, and you are done. Let's see the final result. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to create a page turn logo reveal in After Effects. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the like button and comment. It would be great to know your opinions on my tutorials. Also, you can make requests for new tutorials on interesting effects or animations that you would like to learn. See you soon.